For many years, Endpoint Detection and Response, or EDR, has played a critical role in securing corporate endpoints. Today, we have many more users now working remotely, utilizing multiple different types of devices to access corporate resources that can live on-premise, natively in the cloud, or even span across hybrid environments. This is why so many SOCs have uncovered the value of combining CrowdStrike EDR capabilities with Vectra's threat detection and response to augment their visibility beyond the endpoint and improve their overall security posture in these new dynamic user environments. We have gone to great length to make enabling EDR integration a simple, straightforward process that can be performed natively in the Vectra Detect UI. To set up the CrowdStrike EDR integration, click the Edit button and slide the On-Off toggle. Next, you will enter your client ID and secret, then click the Save button. This is it. The integration between Vectra and CrowdStrike is now active. Vectra Detect will then begin pulling EDR for host artifacts, which are used to aid analysts in identifying hosts as they appear on the network, with information such as hostname, IP address, operating system, last seen timestamp, as well as the isolation state. We have streamlined the investigation workflow, allowing to jump directly between a host detail page in the Vectra Detect UI to the host CrowdStrike EDR console. As threats progress and hosts begin to accumulate detection activity, having the ability during an investigation to pivot with one single click to the CrowdStrike console allows the analyst to quickly correlate signal between EDR and NDR. When a threat has been confirmed, the ability to isolate impacted hosts is paramount when you need to take quick action. Vectra Detect Host Lockdown features does just that. It leverages the power of our native CrowdStrike EDR integration to give analysts the ability to perform endpoint isolation directly from the Detect UI. As an analyst, I can now log this endpoint from the Detect Host page. This is what we refer to as manual host lockdown. This host is managed by CrowdStrike EDR. Let's assume a security investigation is underway and we need to isolate this host. So we will simply click the Log Host button and then specify the amount of time we wish to disable this host, then click Disable. You will then see that the host has been marked as manually disabled, along with the user that performed the action and the timestamp when the action was performed. If we pivot over to the CrowdStrike console, we can see that the host has been contained. In the event that the analyst needs to cancel host lockdown prior to the expiration of the isolation windows, the host can be re-enabled at any time. The second and probably more powerful way to utilize the host lockdown capabilities is via automatic enforcement. Now, this is a great way to scale up your response capabilities because it gives an automated around-the-clock enforcement response based on a set of user-defined criteria. To enable automatic host lockdown, toggle the on-off slider and then choose the amount of time that you wish to temporarily disable host whenever they cross the threshold settings. The threshold are a set of high-fidelity signal that includes the host threat, certainty, and observed privilege score. Whenever all of these conditions are met, Vectra Detect will signal to the CrowdStrike EDR that the host should be put into isolation for the configured isolation window. An ideal use case for when to use automatic host lockdown could be something like anytime your SOC may be overloaded with work or during off hour when your staffing may be low. Good luck and happy hunting. We hope that you take advantage of our native CrowdStrike EDR integration and incorporate host enrichment as well as manual and automatic host lockdown into your team workflow. Thank you.